We saved Dharma from whatever fate those Deep One fools had planned for her. Not that I particularly care, though. People are killed and murdered all the time. I do care about what I gained from saving her. Call me a mercenary if you want. It was for profit and power. It always is with me. Well, maybe not when it comes to Vilya. I have nothing to gain there by us being together, other than love, I suppose. Songs are sung about love and sacrifices are made. Willing sacrifices. For loved ones, that is. I do have it in me to love, it's just not something that comes easily to me. Too much bad history in this world, I suppose. The Montroses never were a loving people. Most of the love in my life comes from my own sister. She was one of the few that actually cared about my well-being. And I in turn learned what it is like to be loved by a sister who was more of a parent to me than my own father. Yes, we are not a people to love easily, except for my sister. As I got older and we went our separate ways, I got the impression from reading her letters that she was a loving and passionate person. It was a side of her that I never knew about. She's an anomaly with our family then. Unless Mother was like that. I never did hear much about her other than from my Uncle Dorian, who used to tell me that she was a wonderful woman, and he missed her. I also got the feeling that Father never really cared much about us after she died. Perhaps he was like that before, I don't know. What a sad, mixed-up family I come from. An alcoholic, abusive father, a mother I never knew, and a dead sister. I have a distant older brother who I haven't communicated with years. I don't even know if he cares if I'm alive, either. It all makes me second-guess my plan to eventually reuse the Montrose name. Well, my sister was a Montrose, and I have a connection there. I really do love her. She may be gone, but my love for her is eternal. It's the only real solid love I have had in my life. My romantic relationships have never really gone anywhere. So taking it slow and being friends with Vilya first is my goal. I don't want to ruin that. I don't want it to turn out like it did with Ivara. The Breton woman that was my lover for much of my time in Morrowind. We were all about having sex as often as we could, in between our work. Though the professor often commented that we liked to disappear together a lot. But as long as it didn't interfere with why we were there, he didn't really care. Before Ivara, there was another Breton woman I was with for a couple of months in North Point, while I was essentially the ward of the victorious Duke, who later became a king. Yeah, the one who killed my father and took the kingdom from us. She was my age, and being tutored by the court wizard. Before that, well, let's just say that there were a few chambermaids who were eager to show me the ways of the bedroom in more ways than one. Some were actually quite pushy about it. I wonder if they thought it would be an easy way to get special privileges from my family, if they had a bastard child from me. Well, regardless, I was young and ignorant. It wasn't love, of course, but I could tell that they really tried with me, hoping the youngest of the Montrose males would fall for one of them and marry one. As I said, love doesn't come easy for us. It has to be the right person, under the right situation. Otherwise, it's just not worth the effort to force it.
I may have a bit of a proposition for you involving the Jemane family you so recently assisted.
Sorry? Sorry, what? What about the Jemane family?
It was kind of you to escort the Jemanes back to Weatherly. However, the original owner of Weatherly left them an even greater legacy. In fact, there's quite a bit more to their family history than meets the eye.
Really?
Want to hear about it?
Of course. Sure, I'll listen.
Excellent. Curiosity should never be denied, is it not so?
I believe
and
so, too.
And who knows? My story may prove profitable to both of us
That's
once
what
it
I'm
has
hoping.
Come to its end. My tale actually begins with the father, Albert Jemane. He was once in my employ, or should I say, the employ of my organization. He was very good at obtaining things that people did not want to part with. A professional thief, to
yes.
put it bluntly. He was assigned to obtain a very valuable item for me. He succeeded, but decided to keep this item for himself. An unfortunate decision. He fled from Coral with his family and was never heard from again. Only his small son, Reynald, was found, wandering alone in the wilderness. Naturally, my associates and I believed he had perished. The wilderness is, after all, a dangerous place. No place to take your family. Then, these many years later, voila! The brother reappears. It seems the rest of the family did not die in the wilderness after all.
What do you want me to do?
Indeed.
There's nothing what is the value point in that house.
Albert Jemane builds Weatherly way out in the middle of nowhere. He was a thief, not a farmer. The only reason to establish such a place would be to stay out of the Coral Guard's sight. I believe that the item Albert stole, which rightly belongs to me, was hidden at the Weatherly settlement. Unfortunately, the notorious Redguard Valley Ogres ransacked the place and probably took all of the loot back with them. If you were to obtain this item somehow and bring it to me, I would pay you very well for it. I can get you started by telling you where the Ogres live. The rest is up to you.
Okay. What can you ask you to tell me about Albert Jemane?
There isn't much to tell you about Albert Jemane. He was one of my best, then he got greedy. The rest is history.
And the Jemane family?
Gilbert and Reynald know nothing of their father's past deeds. If you want to tell them about it, suit yourself.
No, this has nothing to do with them. Okay, so where is the stolen item?
I do not care to describe it. You will know it when you see it, I think. It is not something one of the Ogres should have in his possession.
Okay, then. You're going to show me where the cave is?
Beware. The Redguard Valley is a rough mouth for them.
I couldn't hear with this stupid Oblivion Storm. Beware the Redguard something. And he ran off. A Denmer named Fathis Ules has told me that Albert Jemane, Reynald and Gilbert's father, stole a valuable item from the Thieves Guild many years ago. He's offered to pay me well to return this item to him in Coral. Fathis believes it's now hidden inside of Redguard Valley Cave, oh that's what he's talking about, which he's marked on my map. It's like I can't get away from Coral. Another place to the south. Well, it's pretty close to Weatherly. It's not that far away, I suppose. But, I'm gonna rest the night. And then we can return in the morning. Stop killing cats. See, paintings like this. Well, that's how.
I've been reading all of you of God's worship.
You should adorn your walls.
I like it.
Oh, hello, Villian.
So, what would you like to do next?
Okay, let's go.
Sure.
We've got this cave to go to. It's like I cannot They're leave this city. Some cult murdered the Emperor and are opening the Oblivion Gate. Well then. To the south. To this Redguard something cave. I don't know if we need Fergus, but maybe we should because there's ogres there and that could be very tough. Hoping to leave. Doesn't seem it's gonna happen anytime soon. Okay, we're going to this Redguard cave. I'll summon Fergus, the cat killer, when we get there.
Do is to go to Shadenhall and have a talk with Falak.
We'll go there. We'll go there soon. Alright, so. There seems to be a path through the forest, south of Shadenhall. It's hack dirt, isn't it? Leads pretty much exactly where we're going. If there's any more forts around here, maybe there's more Shadow Banished wine to be held. Be found, I should say. So, according to my map, it's just this way. Is that a goblin? Is that an adventurer fighting a goblin? Looks like it. Huh. Why would it... Stupid, stupid goblin.
I'm not afraid of you.
Oops. My aim is a little
leave
off.
Leave him alone!
That one got him. It's an Argonian. Hello?
What?
The fellow adventurer? Would you like to travel with me? Good idea. Traveling on your own can be dangerous at times, after all. You lead, I'll follow. Oh, guess maybe we don't need to summon Fergus after all. Really nothing on him, so maybe some silver arrows. This is the cave, right? I've arrived at the entrance to Redguard Valley Cave. I should proceed inside. Well, little guess as to what's in here. Stinky, smelly goblins, the friends of orcs. Oh, that's an ogre over there. Both hit.
You don't scare me.
I'm afraid to summon Fergus, there'd be too many people. Oh, there's another one. Can't really see them in the dark. Uh-oh. Pull teeth now. Take their ogre teeth. Good for alchemy. So, we're after an item, which he said he didn't want to tell me what it was. I'll know it when I see it, is what he said. Let's get some torches going. There's a cave down in that depression. Oh, that's the entrance. Okay, so looks like the only way to go is over there. Or here. Let's try this way. There comes an ogre. Yeah, if it's narrow enough, it has to deal with my pet. A mouth on you, Velia. That was my conjured pet. Oh, I forgot about that. We will need Fergus if I'm to... I'll just take everything. I should see about trying to soul trap one of these ogres, actually.
Here comes one. I'm not afraid of you.
Oops, another one. You knocked him back. It's a very powerful Argonian. You can do that. I'm gonna be over encumbered if I keep taking all these teeth. Oh, this place just keeps going on and on. No place can keep going on forever, not even Nern. Here comes another ogre.
Is that the best thing to do, sir? Am I supposed to be in I'm not
a- I fought Mudcrab.
I'm not afraid of you. I'm not afraid of you.
More teeth. Another one. Big hulking form off in the low light. Oh, I'm out of magicka.
Die, damn you.
He's a pretty good fighter, this Argonian.
Let's get this over.
Probably should be using my poisons. I can find it. Where is it? Shock damage. I'm actually getting a little bit low on these, so maybe I'll start saving them. Oh. Was that you that cast that lightning? That look is nice on you, Velia. Okay, where are we? So, did I check out this side of the cavern? There's also another depression down there. Doesn't seem to be any chests. There's no mushrooms. I assume maybe the ogres are eating the mushrooms. Another cave. Okay, let's go through here. I have no idea where this thing is. It could be right here. No traps. No chests. No mushrooms. Just smelly, stinky ogres. Uh-oh. This one is no wimp. Where's my companions when I need them? Ah! Ow.
You don't scare me.
Die, damn you.
Ah. Please finish him.
You don't scare me.
Thing was about to bash my skull in. Ow. Ow. Ah. Is this what he was after? A flawless topaz? There's teeth. Oh, there's a sword. I've retrieved some kind of sword. It has engraving Honorblade of Coral on it. From the Ogre Chieftain. This has to be the item Fathis was seeking. However, due to the nature of the item, I think someone at Castle Coral would be anxious to have this back. I need to decide whether to sell the weapon to Fathis or return it to the castle. Well, you know, if I do return to the castle, they'll probably think highly of me and give me a reward. What am I going to get from Fathless? He's not even part of the Thieves Guild, so it would seem. Oh, my head really hurts. That had to have been the hardest hit I've ever had in the head. And since I've left the prison, I've gotten a lot of hits to the head. Ah. Well, I'll take these. Restore Magicka. Oh, Cure Disease. I can sell that, since I now have the spell. Yeah, I had a terrible, terrible headache. Alright, let's try to make our way out of here. I'm feeling a little bit better as I cast these Restore Health on myself, but pounding headache is still there. Well, I think that's it. There doesn't seem to be much left, so I'm going to return to Castle Coral. I think that's best, and I'm not doing it because I think it's the right thing to do. That's not on my mind. I'm doing it because I am trying to get more prestige for myself, a better name for myself, and at least if I return to them, I know that they'll be more honorable if there's to be a reward involved than to return it to this dark elf who cannot even admit to being in the Thieves Guild. I don't even know if he is or not. And of course, I don't trust the Thieves Guild, even though I am a member of them. Okay, so get rid of the torch, say goodbye to our help. We didn't need Fergus this time around. There's one chest in there, and it had no lock to it. Goodbye, adventurer.
Go ahead, please.
Let's travel on our own again. Thanks for your help. Alright, I hope we meet again. Good luck, and bye. That's very, very helpful, actually. I don't know what to do with a headache this bad, but, where's the horse? Where's Prophet? I know we went up quite high, then dismounted. I think that's Weatherby just over there. I hope those brothers are doing all right after I helped them out, otherwise what a waste of time that would be. There's Prophet. You know, maybe I need to get some kind of magical enchantment to make him glowing. I'll never miss him again. But then again, he's already such a magnet for all the things out here trying to kill us, and they go to him instead of me, that may not be a good idea. St. John's wort. I'm a little, I really feel like I need to go to sleep, actually. My head was hit so bad. Ow. Let's go. Let's return to Coral. I spent some time here, back at the inn. Vilya has said it's not a good thing to sleep, but I should relax and rest. She knows about head wounds, she said. Something about a concussion? I did believe that I heard about that when I was in the Arcane University. It's something you receive when you get a mighty blow to the head. And that ogre did that to me. And I should probably spend the night here in the inn before we do anything else. She says it's very, very dangerous to just leave it. So she's using her healing magic on me. And I do feel better, I'm very dizzy, actually, and tired. But we'll go to the Coral Castle in the morning. No, sorry. Let's go.
Wow. Well met.
Hello. Without my suit of armor, I could really move fast, especially with that necklace I'm wearing. I almost feel like I'm on Prophet again. Oh. Well, I feel much better. I'm a little dizzy, but with healing magic, especially the kind that Vilya knows, even though she's not the greatest healer, but she does know how to, a lot of these remedies that she was taught at home. Well, Castle Coral is supposed to be open from 9 to 6, right? So, time is approximately, it's after 8. Or is it 8 to 6?
Do you need something?
What?
Hello again, Laith.
Hello, I'm Laith Wavrick, the Chief Herald and Countess Velga's attendant.
We've met.
Welcome to Coral.
Okay, so I have a stolen item.
Many years ago, when the Count was still alive, a daring thief stole the ancient Honorblade of Coral from out of this castle. Why?
Why? I don't know, but I was... Here's the sword. It wasn't
this
me.
This is incredible. I never thought to see this sword again. How did you... Never mind. One should not look a gift horse in the mouth. Please accept my thanks on behalf of the people of Coral for restoring this sword and the honor of our city. As a token of our gratitude, I bestow upon you a symbol of honor and heroism. The escutcheon of Coral. You've done a great service to Coral, and you should be proud.
Escutcheon, okay. All right, thank you. What can you tell me about Countess Valga?
The Countess is in attendance. Proper etiquette is expected.
Of course.
Fare thee well.
Oh, this is very heavy, what he gave me. It's a heavy shield. Well, oh, there's an enchantment of reflect damage on it, so... What? It's worth an amazing amount. If I could sell it for that high, I only know... You know, I know somebody right by... Was it the way in? That person there. I could sell it to him for 2,000 septims. Not sure why I'm over-encumbered, though. Did I... Create a lot of potions. Maybe that was it. No, I don't think so. I'll have to go over my items. Maybe I have a lot of ingredients. Oh, the ogre teeth. That's right. I'll have to make some potions. Hello again, my lady. Pleased to see you again. Hope all is well. And your husband's sword has been returned. You are
Coral
welcome.
Really is a lovely town.
Coral is a lovely town. Okay, so we need to sell this shield. And I need to make potions, so for that...
Nice people and pleasant.
He's burden. Let's go.
Hello.
What?
Hello?
What do you want?
Heard any good rumors lately?
I heard that someone saw the ghost of Lord Vlindrel again along the road to Bruma. I think I'll avoid that road at night for a while.
I wonder if I go at night if I'll see Goodbye. This ghost. Interesting. But I don't... I do plan to go to my tower, actually. And to do that, I'm going to have to go to... Let's make potions. I'll go sell them. I can sell them in the Imperial City. It is the morning. If you can believe it. Seems like a stormy night, but no. I'll get my items for that I need to fully activate Proscrag Tower. And I'll go make potions and sell everything.
Yes?
Try to reduce the
what
weight
is it,
I'm carrying.
Sincere?
Oh, I can really move fast. Imperial City. Alright, so let's go get this taken care of. Hello again.
Do you need something?
Yes, I've returned for my promotion. I also have a delivery. There you go. How about my promotion?
Good work. You are very efficient. I have another task for you.
Go on.
Recently, I've been getting requests from innkeepers around the countryside. They're in need of supplies. I've added a new delivery board on the shelf opposite to the main board. Good luck.
Okay.
Talk to me again after you've delivered 3 packages.
I've heard that the Blackwood isn't so bad once you get used to the flies and being lost all the time. And the zombies, and the will-o'-the-wisps.
the Blackwood? Oh, way down by Leowin and Blackmarsh, yeah. The zombies? He said he added a new... Is there a new board? Well, I don't see anything. Yeah, I don't see anything, so I have no idea what he's talking about. Okay. Whatever. Let's go see if I can't find... don't you have to be there at midnight to find him? Deliver, I can find one at any board at any of the branches. Oh, talk to Goldhorn if I'm due for a promotion. Okay, so it's one of the branches. He wasn't very clear. Preparing the orrery? I forgot about that. But, let's see. Independent Thiever, reached my goal. I need to go see Armand sometime. I know where he likes to hang out, but it's the middle of the day. I don't know if he's going to be there right now. Yes, I move so quietly and so quickly. It's actually good to dress like this when I'm a thief. Perhaps I should look into... getting a set of light armor, but that's probably very heavy.
You're as good as dead.
I don't know who you're after, Vilya. Did you see something out there?
You're a creep. You're as good as dead.
She has an ebony bow.
You think
bow.
You can beat me? Go ahead.
I don't even have an ebony mace.
You think you can
I've got
beat
an ebony
me?
Shield and... armor, though, except for the helm.
Die.
Hello?
You think you can beat me?
Well, I guess I had to come here at the proper time. Okay, so let's go to the Arcane University. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.